I'm in the RV today, and tomorrow I'm going to make some pork fried rice, but today I'm going to put my marinade together for my char siu pork. If you watched my Asian soup recipe, you know I spent a month touring Asia back in 1985 when I was a chef in Europe, and after I came back to the U.S., I worked in a ton of restaurants. One of the restaurants I worked in was called The Great Wok. I worked in that restaurant for 3 years, making all kinds of Chinese food. So, I've learned a few things, learned a lot of substitutions, learned some things that you wouldn't believe they do in Chinese restaurants, and what they use to get the end result. Some of them good, some of them bad. So, in my Asian cooking series that I'm starting right now, I'm going to tell you about a lot of the substitutions and shortcuts that you can use, and that also restaurants use that you may not know. But traditional char siu pork is made with Asian five spice, and Asian five spice has star anise, cloves, cinnamon, Szechuan peppercorns, and fennel seeds. That's traditional Asian five spice. Now there's a Japanese seven spice, and that's totally different. That seven spice has chilies, dried orange peel, sesame seeds, ginger, seaweed, and Szechuan peppercorns. And then there's a 13 spice out there. It's a little hotter. It's got a lot more heat ingredients in it. But then also Badia makes a 14 spice that even kicks it up a little bit more. So in my char siu pork marinade today, I'm going to be using the Badia 5 spice. I'm going to be using the ground ginger as opposed to fresh ginger that I used in my soup the other day, because I don't want those little ginger pieces all over the pork. So we're going to use some ground ginger. I'm going to use soy sauce. I'm going to use brown sugar. I'm going to use honey. I'm going to use this ginger sweet chili sauce that I told you about in my last video, and I'm going to use the Korean style barbecue sauce. Now both of these made by Food Lion are some really good sauces, and I'll put a picture up of some other brands. Now, as opposed to the red bean curd, I'm going to use some chili garlic sauce today. We're going to use Carlo Rossi sweet red. We're going to use a quarter cup of that. We're going to use a quarter cup of sloe gin, because you know gin has junipers. You can use regular gin, but I want that red color, so I'm going to use the sloe gin. And I'm going to use the sweet vermouth. That's going to be my substitution for my Shaoxing, however you want to say it, wine. Now, Shaoxing comes from Shaoxing, China. It's a burgundy wine. That's all it is. The traditional Shaoxing wine is a burgundy wine. You can drink it. But the stuff they sell in the markets over here in the U.S. and are passing it off as Shaoxing wine is not. It's really just cooking wine. Now, some substitutions for Shaoxing wine. You can do what I'm going to do. Or you can just use, you know, that Rossi, and there's a couple other brands. You know that big, huge bottle of wine on the bottom shelf in the wine department of your grocery store? You get that burgundy. You can use that wine in this recipe. In fact, you can use that wine in a lot of recipes, and I have. In fact, there's some, I've used that wine on some recipes I've already uploaded to YouTube. Now, you can use this Carlo Rossi I got, the sweet red, just that. Or you can use sherry, sweet sherry or dry sherry. You can use marin or soju. You can use sake or any rice wine. You can use white wines. You can use a Riesling. It's kind of fruity. That's not too bad. A Moscato. You can use a vinegar mixture. You can take balsamic vinegar or you can take apple cider vinegar. And you can mix that with apple juice. You can mix it with grape juice. You can mix it with apple butter. Strawberry jam, and I'm going to tell you, I've done that apple cider vinegar and strawberry jam. I've even done balsamic vinegar and strawberry jam. A strawberry wine cooler with one of those vinegars. Sloe gin or gin. Just sweet vermouth. Or the combination that I'm going to put together today, and I'll show you that. And again, the reasons you would use a wine or some sort of sweet acid is to penetrate that meat, to get that redness, to get that tenderness that you need for char siu pork. And then the other ingredients that I'm going to show you is going to be the flavor and the stickiness that you want. Now for this char siu pork, you can use a pork roast like I'm doing. You can use pork belly, pork butt, pork shoulder, pork neck, pork hocks. I make a wild hock recipe with this ginger sweet chili sauce that I'm going to make for you shortly. You can even use it on pork loin and pork chops. All right, we're going to take, it's a half a cup of this sweet red wine. We're going to take a half a cup of the sweet red. And a half a cup of the sloe gin. As you can tell, that's basically all I use sloe gin for, is for cooking. And we're going to take a half a cup of the sweet vermouth. That is going to be in place of the Shaoxing wine. Now that's going to be very similar to the Shaoxing wine. You can go ahead and taste it and you'll see for yourself. It's pretty darn close. So the next thing I'm going to do is 1 cup of soy sauce. We want our pork completely submerged in this marinade. So that's why we're making so much. 1 cup of soy sauce. Now we're going to do 2 tablespoons of brown sugar. And it doesn't have to be precise. It can be heaping, it can be level, whatever you want to do. 2 tablespoons of brown sugar. 1 tablespoon of honey. I'm not going to put that in that spoon. I'm just going to eyeball that. We want this to be sticky when we're done, so that's the reason behind that. And it adds a little sweetness. Now we're going to do 2 tablespoons of hoisin sauce, however you want to pronounce it. I've heard it pronounced both ways. Not by Asian people. So 2 tablespoons of hoisin sauce. And we're going to do 2 tablespoons of this ginger sweet sauce. 2 tablespoons of sweet chili sauce. And 2 tablespoons of the Korean barbecue sauce. And again, I'm really impressed with the Food Lion brand. I'm splashing this everywhere. Now, we're going to go with 1 tablespoon of this chili garlic paste. Nice heaping tablespoon. That fly came in when I went outside a minute ago, and I have yet to catch it. There's an outtake. It's going to be in my bloopers about that fly. Oh, and also, I spilt the red wine. Now, we're going to do 1/4 teaspoon of this ginger, this ground ginger. Only a quarter, I just got that all over me. 1/4 teaspoon of the ground ginger. I'll put that other lid back on there in a second. I can't get to my sink to rinse off that measuring spoon. Oh, dropped it right on the floor. I'm gonna have stains everywhere. All right. Might have to get a different, Nah, I think I'm good. Now, on the 5 spice, it's quite strong. And I'm going to go with 1 tablespoon. If I don't dump it all in there, because I'm not sticking that sticky spoon in that jar. Now, if you like smoky pork, smoky char siu, you got a couple options. You can use a little liquid smoke, but you got to be very sparingly because it's strong. You can use that. You can use that sweet and spicy chipotle. And I've got a video that I haven't uploaded yet of all my spices, and I talk about this one. You can add a teaspoon of that. Or you can add a teaspoon of this Grill Mates mesquite for, I even splashed over there, mesquite for a little smoky flavor. But what we're going to do today is we're going to add a teaspoon of the sweet and spicy chipotle just for that smokiness, because it will give it a little smokiness. And last but not least, we're going to do a couple jiggers of sesame oil in this mixture. Now, we're going to give that a stir. It's quite thick. It's going to take you a little while. And if you splash it anywhere, it will stain. So just remember that if any comes out, it goes on your shirt, your shoes, your counter, your floor. Better get some spray bleach on your counters and floors real quick. Some kind of cleaner, because it will stain them. I know from experience. All right. Now you can really smell this. What I'm going to do, if I don't knock the camera down, is we're going to give this a little taste. That is almost absolutely a perfect char siu pork barbecue marinade. You can't get any closer to the real thing. Trust me on this. You're just gonna have to try it, because It's going to come out really, really good. Let's get our pork, and we're going to rinse our pork off, and then we're going to salvage it down in all this marinade. All right, so we have our pork. Now, we're going to pour our marinade on this pork, and we want it completely covered. That's why we make so much. You want it submerged in. Guess I could have added a little bit more, huh? Now, you can cut that. If you're just making fried rice, you can cut that pork roast lengthways in the middle and have two pieces. But I'd rather have the moisture and only have the char siu on the outside. It will permeate that meat, but you know how it's going to be on the outside when it's done. So we're going to cover this and let it marinate overnight. Now, you can only, if you want, you can let it go 4 to 6 hours, but I'm going to let it marinate overnight, and I'm going to turn it several times over the next 24 hours so that that meat soaks up that flavor and that color. And then we're going to roast this in the oven at 350 degrees for like 2.5 hours. Okay, I marinated that pork for 24 hours. It's just coming out of the oven now. Whew. Thing is hot. Anyway, there she be. We're gonna let it rest for a while. I cooked it for 2 hours at 350, and let me grab a fork here. I dumped most of that marinade off, and I put a little bit of that ginger sweet chili sauce on top. Cooked it covered with aluminum foil at 350 for 2 hours. Now we're going to let it rest till it cools a little bit. We're going to slice that up. That's going to be our char siu pork for our pork fried rice. Yesterday we made our char siu pork marinade and marinated our pork roast overnight. This morning I cooked it. I got it cut up, diced up for our pork fried rice. I got some white rice. And I want to show you this Audicook little pan here. It's 800 watts. It's an electric pan, and it's pretty neat. You turn it on, you see a little light right here. You can go low, medium, or high. You can cook rice in it. You can do soup, stews, all kinds of things. It's only 800 watts. It works great on the inverter and the solar. So that's something that I would recommend. It comes this nice little spatula that you can use for all kinds of cooking. Anyway, I'll put the link down in the description. The other thing you can use, especially in an RV, if you don't have a wok, is, move the camera over here. I got this, I have an old electric skillet that I use, and you can see it on some of my older videos, but I just picked up this Drew Barrymore beautiful 5-in-1 expandable skillet. Now it has an extra ring that you can make the skillet taller. It has this little thing you stick in the back. There's two little holes that you can put your lid up if you want. Doesn't work well underneath this cabinet, but it may work in your situation. And it has this cooking rack that you can fold out the bottom and set in there to broil, cook, steam, all kinds of different things. Anyway, it's 1500 watts max. I usually use it on 350, 375. So you're never really maxing out the wattage in an RV. So it's a pretty decent unit and it's really sturdy. The base has this rubber feet on it, so it's not going to be knocked off very easy. I have an old stainless steel one that it can come off of this counter pretty easy. Anywayif you don't have a wok, you can do your fried rice in an electric skillet. Now we have our carrots diced up, our onions. We're going to micrograte some ginger and garlic. We have four eggs. We're going to put a little bit of half and half in it just to make them a little bit more fluffy. And then I'm going to do them in a skillet instead of the wok because I don't like how the wok picks up. The eggs pick up the flavor of the wok. So I'm going to do the eggs in a little skillet here in a second and I'll show you that. Oh, to cook your rice, normally it's 1 cup of rice to 1.5 cups of water. Sometimes I use 2 cups of water, especially when I do it in the oven, to 1 cup of rice. If you do 2 cups of rice, I always do 4 cups of water. If you do 3 cups of rice, I usually do 5 cups of water. So it varies depending on your cooker and how you're cooking it, whether you're cooking on the stove, in a pot, or in the oven. It's just slightly different. Oh, and we're using some bird's eye sweet peas. So we're going to go ahead and beat up our eggs. I got a little bit of half and half in there to make them a little bit more fluffy. That should do it. Go ahead. I got a teaspoon of oil in there. We're going to go ahead and turn on this burner. Turn it on medium. We're going to go ahead and pour our eggs in. It's only going to take about a minute and a half. I don't really use sesame oil in my wok because I don't like how it creates an off flavor with the metal. So I'll tend to use light olive oil or this Crisco vegetable oil in my wok. Anyway, I used a little bit of Crisco in this skillet. Now we're pretty much done there. We're gonna go ahead and put these in a bowl and set them aside, and we're going to add them back into our fried rice in just a little bit. And we're going to go ahead and put our wok on. I'm going to add like a tablespoon of oil. It might be a little bit more than a tablespoon. We'll let that come up to temperature a second. We're going to put our vegetables in. Our onion. There's our carrots. We get a little bit of water because we're going to add just a tiny bit of water here in a second. Get those coated. I think I'm going to need a bigger wok. I think I made too much rice. Okay, now we're going to micrograte a little bit of ginger in here. not much. And then we're gonna micrograte some garlic, 3 little cloves, now we're gonna add our water. If you got a cover for your wok, you can go ahead and cover it at this time. It's not going to take long. Go ahead and turn up the heat a little bit. My onions and carrots have gone about 3.5-4 minutes now. I'm going to go ahead and put them in this little dish. Then wipe this wok out. We're gonna go ahead and put our wok back on, turn it back down a little bit. Right now I'm gonna dump the peas in that bowl with those onions and carrots, garlic and ginger. Now we're gonna add just a tiny bit of oil and we're gonna sear our pork. That come up to temperature. I add a little bit of that garlic ginger sweet chili sauce that I showed you yesterday. I put just a tiny bit on the top of this pork. We're going to go ahead and sear this pork. Let it go about 4 to 5 minutes just to get a slight char on it. Put a few little burnt ends on these. Now we're going to dump this right into this bowl as well. Now I'm in an RV and I got a small wok. So if I would have a bigger stove and a bigger wok, I'd do all this stuff a little differently. But what we're going to do is after we get it all done, we're going to put it in that electric skillet that I showed you a minute ago. So I'm not going to be able to do all this rice at once because it's a little too much rice. But I'm going to do about half. And we want to get a good sear on this rice. Just keep it turning and get some sear on it. And then we're going to add a little bit more oil. But we're going to do this in 2 batches. We're going to add our soy sauce. And we're going to put it over here in this electric skillet I've got on. That wok is pretty hot. See how the oil is already sizzling? You want to toast those kernels. Get a good toast on them, keep them moving. All right, we're gonna put this in our electric skillet, and we're going to do the other batch of rice. Our electric skillet's pretty warm too. You want a few of those. You want a few of those ones that are stuck on there that are got a few little crunchies on them. You want those like that. It adds texture and flavor to your fried rice. Okay, we're going back on the skillet, back on the burner. Gonna add our oil again. Doesn't take long, that wok is hot. We'll do the rest of our rice here. I got white sticky rice. Thinking of it is I made 4 cups. We're gonna go ahead and do this just like we did the other, and then I'll show you the next step. Second batch of rice is done. I'm gonna put it in that electric skillet. Now I'm gonna go back in with the wok again and a little bit more oil. This time all this is going back in this wok. You know, you have to do this in stages in an RV. I'm gonna heat up everything, and we're gonna add a little bit of soy sauce to this as well. Oh, that was funny. Well, we added a little bit more soy sauce. Turn that burner back up again. I'm going to leave that in and not cut that one. Sometimes I cut my mistakes and then put them in a blooper file. I'm only going to heat this up to those peas come up to temperature. Doesn't take long because they're pretty warm already. Shut my fan off. We're just about done. This is already up to temperature. The peas are warm. We're going to go ahead and dump this in with our rice in the electric skillet. Bring you over here and show you. Then we're gonna add our egg. Shut my burner off here. All right. Do the tripod over here. All right, we're gonna stir this up. I made too much rice and my wok was too small. I have a huge steel wok that only can be used on, well, I'm going to use it on that outside Coleman grill I just got. That was one of the reasons why I got that, so I could use my bigger wok, because I can't use it in the house because I have one of those glass stoves. So all right, now we're gonna add our egg in. I like the egg done this way, so you get nice fluffy pieces of egg rather than charred, burnt, soy flavored egg. It's just my personal preference. Now we're going to turn this up a little bit so that it heats up. We're going to let this all incorporate and then we're going to serve this up. I think she's pretty good. Let me get a plate here. And my serving spoon is nowhere to be found. I know what I did. I used it for the rice. Oh well. Should have made a little bigger roast. That pound and it was a pound 1.33. I think I could have got a pound and a half roast. I think it would have been fine. All right. That pork is unbelievable. I'm telling you, you gotta try it. Mm. This beats anything you can get with takeout. I'll turn my skillet down now because she's hot. That pork is done perfectly. The egg is fluffy. The rice is toasted. The onions and carrot are translucent. Well, the onions are. Carrots a little bit. Got that garlic, ginger, and the peas. Alright. So that's my pork fried rice recipe. You gotta try that pork. For Tom's Manly Meals. Mm. Wow. I'm Tom Moore. Mm. That pork is unbelievable. Good luck to you. Mm-mm-mm. We're gonna make some donuts in the wok. I'm gonna use this Grands buttermilk biscuits, not the flaky ones, the regular biscuits. We're going to cut those into quarters, or you can cut it into thirds if you like the bigger donuts. We're going to use some cinnamon sugar and some oil. Now I use this Microban sanitizer for all my counters, my sink, around the stove, the stovetop. I use it all over the RV. I even have a spray. I even have this Microban sanitizing spray, fresh scent, that I use in the bathroom and when I change the sheets and spray the mattresses and everything. So I'll put the links down in the description for those two. Now let's get started on these donuts. Now I have my wok. Let's go ahead and move the camera over here. I keep forgetting about that slide out ledge. All right, let's go ahead and start our burner. And we're gonna put a nice portion of cooking oil in the bottom of this wok. I think that'll be good. So to know if your wok is up to temperature, you drop a little bit of water, just a tiny drop off of the end of a knife, and you'll see it's up to temperature. Now we're gonna turn it back just a tiny bit, back to about medium. We gotta our biscuits cut in the fours, quarters. And you can roll into a little ball if you want. Or you can just drop them in. But you gotta leave some room because they will expand. We're gonna do about half of them, and then we'll do the other half. Go ahead and keep them moving a little bit. Turn my burner up just a little bit more. I don't want it to cool off too much. It's not going to take long. I think I did turn it down a little too low, didn't I? Take about 4.5 minutes. They almost done. Let me get my cinnamon sugar ready. You can use powdered sugar on them if you like, but I think cinnamon sugar is good. Now let's go ahead and put the others in. That little half can will make like 20 donuts. Drop that oil on the stove there. See that? Completely done inside. That's how you make the little Chinese donuts you see in the Chinese restaurants. Little buffets. Sometimes you get them in takeout. All it is biscuit dough fried. I worked for a Great Walk, and that's all he done was go get some Pillsbury. Actually, no, it wasn't. It was those cheap ones, like the store brand ones. You know, the real cheap biscuits. That's what he would use. All right, for Tom's Manly Meals, Chinese donuts, I'm Tom Moore. Good luck to you. Look at those. Ain't they gorgeous?